Before we get stuck into how to perform a manual weight cell differential count, it is probably useful to understand why we'd want to do one in the first place. Depending on the technology used, the analyzer is able to identify weight cells based on their size and granularity. This is how it determines the number of cells for the 5-cell autodifferential. It's also able to flag if there may be immature granulocytes or blast cells present, but it cannot identify what types. This is where a biomedical scientist would look at the scatter plot and determine the need for a manual diff. A manual differential count may also be needed if the analyzer gives a white cell interference flag due to the presence of other things such as cryoglobulins. The presence of these may give a false differential, and so confirmation is needed. After the analyzer has done the white cell count, it quantifies how many of each there are based on the percentage. For example, if the total white cell count was 15.0 and 80% were neutrophils, the absolute neutrophil count would be 12.0. The other 20% would consist of the lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. Depending on the patient, there may also be other cells present, such as blasts or myelocytes, for example, which we'd quantify by doing a manual differential count. Before we actually start the manual differential count, there's a few final things to check. Firstly, ensure that the blood film you're about to look at or perform the manual differential count on is the same as a record you have pulled up on the computer screen. Check the name and the sample identification number. Secondly, it's useful to know how many cells will be counted. Most laboratory information management systems default to 100 cells, but if the total white cell count is high, it may be better to do a 200 or 300 cell count to give an accurate representation of the cells present. If the total white cell count is low, then a 50 cell count may be enough as the white cells are so scanty. Start by looking at the blood film under low power to see the quality of the smear and the staining. A link will pop up in the top right hand corner for a video on how to do this, so if you're unsure, please do check it out. I'll also leave a link in the description below. White cells don't distribute evenly over the slide. In the tail, you're more likely to find neutrophils and less lymphocytes. Monocytes are probably the only cells that are evenly distributed. Large immature cells such as blasts, promyelocytes and myelocytes preferentially distribute to the edges rather than the center of the film. That's not to say there are none in the center, but this is a general observation. You may even get areas where cells are clumped. This particular sample is from a patient with chronic myeloid leukemia. The total white cell count was 229. And so a standard 100 cell differential count would not give a true representation of the cells present in this case. It'll be apt to do a 300 or 400 cell count instead. Start by finding the edge of the smear and work your way in until you are in an area where the cells are close together without any large gaps in between and the morphology can easily be seen. Make sure the cells aren't overlapping either. Pick a fill to start, and when you're ready, count the different cells present. Once finished, take a point of reference at the edge of the field. I usually pick a cell and move the field until that is out of the picture. This will ensure you do not count the same cells repeatedly. Continue to move along until the cells start overlapping and it becomes too thick. Go up a field and then travel in the opposite direction until it becomes too thin. This method compensates for uneven distribution between the tail and the body, but not the center and the edge. So if the standard 100 cells are counted, only a small area of the blood film would be covered. A modified battlement method overcomes some of the issues with the distribution of the cells. It is a compromise between the method shown previously and another in which, rather than moving horizontally parallel to the long edge of the slide, we move vertically up and down instead. In this modified battlement method, two fields are counted close to the edge of the film, and then four perpendicular, and then another two fields parallel to the edge, and so on. Due to the sheer imprecision of the manual differential count caused by the small numbers of cells being counted, maldistribution of the cells would have a very small consequence. If there are aggregates of white cells, however, then the inaccuracy would be much higher